Hi everyone, and welcome back to Doll Star. So you might be saying, Brock, where have you been? You said you were coming back in like January of this year, and it has now July. Also, why aren't you showing face? Well, divas, we're going back to how it started, because I kind of look like trash right now, so you're not getting to see my face. But I've wanted to come back to AGIG and AGTube for a hot minute, but I got really caught up in school and trying to find a job and also getting ready to move. And, you know, this summer I really wanted to take some time to like recenter myself and like remember who I am. And that meant that, you know, I put a lot of things that I wanted to do on the back burner because I needed to really focus on the things that I needed to do. Now that that's over with, hi, yes, you are just seeing my hands. Look at the nails. Actually, don't look at them. They're kind of messed up. Today, I brought you a quick little unboxing video. It was my birthday about a week ago, and this past Saturday, me and all of my friends went to the American Girl store to do a little birthday brunch, and I got to have the cake and everything. It was such a fun experience to have as a full-grown adult. Because I went to American Girl on my birthday, or not on my birthday, but for my birthday to eat, I decided that I was gonna give myself a birthday present. Now, I've wanted another doll for quite some time, but I like really didn't have the means for it. And I was actually given birthday money from my grandparents and my great uncle. And so I had a little extra money to spare that I didn't feel guilty, like overspending, I guess. So I decided to buy a doll. And the doll I got is Princess Tiana. When these first came out, I was not a huge fan of them just because I'm not a huge Disney person, but Tiana has always been one of my favorite Disney princesses. And when I went to Disney World for the first time back, like right before COVID, 2019, LOL, I bought a doll at the Florida Orlando American Girl store. I don't know if that's even still open. RIP if it isn't, but anyways, when I was there, I bought number 80 and I named her after Tiana because Tiana was one of my favorite Disney princesses I got to meet. Her friend was very kind and a great actress. With that being said, the Tiana doll was kind of a no-brainer. She really grew on me, especially with the Claudie mold. I love the Claudie mold. So I'm gonna go get some scissors and we're gonna unbox her, and I'm gonna do a short little review of her. Here is Tiana. Let's open her. I did only buy the doll because the outfits are quite expensive. If I do have another reward coming this month, I might buy her green jacket, yellow dress, I think is the outfit. I think that outfit's really cute. I really do like how they did these boxes, low key. Like, I like having the animated character of Tiana down here, and then like the doll. I don't love it for every one of the dolls. You know, they started doing the pictures, I think with the Truly Me's, and I miss when it was just that little circle up top that had their face. Anyways, that's a constructive criticism for Mattel. So here she is in the box. She is so beautiful. And I won't lie, I did feel a little guilty after buying her because I'm currently getting prepared to move. And so like getting another doll, especially an American Girl right now, was kind of like probably not the most ideal for me to do. Here's her tiara. But getting another doll wasn't really like ideal, especially because I already have 4 here in my current apartment. But I haven't bought a doll in so long, and it's my birthday, and I deserve to treat myself every once in a while. But overall, seeing these dolls in person definitely changed my thoughts thoughts on the Disney line too. I'm still not sold on either Cinderella or Ariel, but I love Tiana. Oh my God, I can't wait. Oh, she's coming out of the box. They boxed these really weird. I don't like how they didn't put the shoes on. I don't know. Oh, it was probably to accommodate for the hairstyle. I could do a whole other video on my thoughts on American Girl right now, especially with the Girl of the Year release and everything that's gonna be happening within like probably the next 2 months, which is crazy. I miss when the Girl of the Year would just come out on January 1st. That was such a simpler time. They packaged her shoes separately. Oh. Why was that tape down there if that's not even how you open the bag? Okay, come on, little heels. How have y'all been feeling about the recent releases from American Girl? Like the last one, I don't think there was much of, because I think the last one was the red, white, and blue set, which, you know, America's America. They kind of do that every year from what I remember. I know recently, just the other day, there was a new baby and the mini bitty baby for the American Girl dolls. There was a new bitty baby released and a bathtub set, I think. I don't know, I haven't been back to the store since last week. Okay, I put all her stuff on. So far, her face is so pretty. I'm most likely gonna remove her eyelashes just because I've done that with all of the new dolls. I don't love the eyelashes on the new dolls. Her lips are the only thing that I like not in love with her lips, and this is pretty much the same on every one of them I could find. They are very much underpainted. I don't know, maybe one day I'll get her to get a lip repaint, but that day won't be anytime soon, I fear. It's so crazy that American Girl now carries dolls that aren't even like their original characters. Beyond, you know, the Truly Me line. Anyways, let's go ahead and review her.
Okay, so I don't have my microphone currently, so please bear with me, but here is Tiana, fully out of the box in all of her glory. So here is her crown. It is that glittery green band with the yellow chiffon, I believe. I don't know, I'm not a fabric expert, but I just sat it under her ponytail. One of my favorite pieces that she comes with is her gold necklace with the green gems. I'm not sure what gems these are, but I think they're beautiful. As you can see on the waistband of the dress, you have the little flower, and that's her bodice. And then underneath the flower, I love, 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 love the vine detailing that I think is just embroidery thread. I think that's super cool. Here are her cream slash yellow gloves, and you can see kind of some of the glitter on the dress. She also comes with her green open-toed with gold trim heels. And yeah, I love her face. This is just a close-up of her face. Her eye color is so pretty, especially on the skin tone. Ugh. And as you can see, here's another clip of her crown with the ponytail sat on top. Of course, you see the hairnet that's, you know, creating the hairstyle. And she does have two tendrils on her temples, and then also two little tendrils up on her forehead.
Overall, I'm very much in love with my purchase. She's so cute. Typically, I would like rush to take off the character clothes because, again, I'm not really like a character collector. I like to dress my dolls in my own way, but I think I'm gonna keep her in this just for a little bit of time before I take the hair down and everything, because I believe her hairstyle is actually sewn in. So I don't want to have to try and recreate that if I get sad she's not Tiana. So I am gonna keep her in her, I guess, me outfit for a little bit. And maybe once I get her second outfit that I really want, I'll change her or I'll just leave her be. I mean, I did buy her a pair of glasses when she becomes like a modern, you know, doll, but who knows if I'll end up using them yet. Anyways, this is my unboxing and review of the American Girl x Disney Tiana doll. Again, I'm in love with her. I'm so happy that I decided to buy her for my birthday, because that means I can justify buying a doll. Overall, I really love her and I can't wait to add her to my full collection. So yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video and we will see you later. Bye.